Today I'm going to talk about three different words: the word hour, the word house, and the word about dying, the verb for to die, and how they change, what are their equivalents. For example, in the news, you see the presenters, and in many of these TV channels, they say, we see you at the top of the hour, or the news is going to be on top of the hour. On top of the hour, they translate it على رأس الساعة. They translate it as على رأس الساعة. In Arabic, there is no such term على رأس الساعة. يعني هل هناك ذنب للساعة أو رأس الساعة؟ In Arabic, we say في تمام الساعة. ألتقيكم في تمام الساعة. And not على رأس الساعة. Talking about hour, at the 11th hour, which is another it's an expression, at the 11th hour. ترجمة at the 11th hour means في الساعة الحادية عشرة. But that doesn't mean the term here, or the idiom, does not mean that. It means you're doing things, you're still making changes at the last hour. يعني في آخر دقيقة ممكن, أو في الدقيقة الأخيرة, أو في الساعة الأخيرة. يعني تقوم, لازلت تقوم بتغييرات في الدقيقة الأخيرة أو في الساعة الأخيرة. At the 11th hour. After hours, it means بعد ساعات الدوام. After hours, بعد ساعات الدوام. Office hours, the office hours, it means أوقات الدوام. Office hours, أوقات الدوام, أو the office hours. Out of hours, خارج أوقات الدوام, أو خارج ساعات الدوام. So this is for the word hour. Now for the word house. Of course, we know the word house means مبنى أو بيت, دار, منزل. But sometimes it can a little bit change. A house of worship, بيت عبادة, بيت العبادة, بيت العبادة. Large house learned, or large house heard the singer. When you say large house heard the singer, يعني ثمة حضور كبير جدا, أو حضور حضر كثيرون لسماع هذا المغني أو المغني. إذن حضور حضر كثيرون لسماع, أو للاستمتاع, if you like, لسماع المغني. حضر كثيرون لسماع المغني. And then we have a publishing house, دار نشر. And then we have full house. For example, full house in the theater. We have a full house in the theater. يعني جميع المقاعد في المسرح مشغولة أو محجوزة, مشغولة. Full house. The third word, which is to die. There are many expressions in English meaning to die, depending on whether it's formal or informal. One of the expressions which is informal, to kick the bucket. To kick the bucket means يعني يرفس أو يركل السطل أو الوعاء. And it means dies, يموت. وكلمة يموت في الإنجليزية, ألطف كلمة لها في الإنجليزية لكلمة يموت هي pass away. There is an Indian usage of the verb, of a verb, يموت, is to expire. And then, of course, there is other things, but may not be used in for humans, you say perish, which means halaka. I mean, usually perish is used for fruit and veg. يعني الخضرة والفواكه. Sometimes they might use very slang, snuff it. He snuffed it. يعني لفظ نفسه الأخير. Bite the dust also means to die, and depart is also to die. And in the throes, there's another expression, in the throes of death, يعني يحتضر أو في آخر أنفاسه. I hope that you've learned something from these two or three words, how to translate them. Have a nice day.